Prodigal Steve returns to Stardew Valley. How's it going, everybody? Last episode was fine. We had a little bit of a frame issue, and it looks like that might be... It looks like it's sorted itself out. It looked okay on the video. I mean, feel free to correct me if I'm wrong on that. I did just update my driver this morning. So I still have my V-Sync and everything on. I'm not gonna try and rock the boat too much all at the same time. Instead, I'll see if maybe the driver update doesn't sort it out, and if not, then I guess I'll start messing around with settings. But beyond that behind-the-scenes kind of stuff that you may or may not care about, we actually do have an agenda today here in Stardew, as opposed to my usual, well, I guess we'll just kind of play it by ear and see what comes along system. So today, as I promised last episode, we're going to crack into some geodes. We do need to go to Clint's anyway to get our watering can back. It is going to rain tomorrow, or it's supposed to start storming tomorrow. So our crops might be okay with just like one day of not being watered, but I would rather not chance it. So what we're going to do... Oh, actually, I'm going to go grab these solar essences as well, because I said I wanted to crack into these geodes, which is true, but I also want to go down and see the wizard at some point today. I don't know when he's open, so I think we just wander through town, check the bulletin board, see if maybe there's anything going on there, and then head over to Clint's, get our watering can, come back, water our crops, then head down to the wizard. I think that'll be a fairly good game plan for this first day, and we're actually getting close to done with summer here. All right, that's a calendar. I've missed a ton of birthdays. Sebastian wants some jade. We actually did just get jade in the mine, so we might as well hook him up. It's just gonna sit in our inventory otherwise. I should probably sell a lot of the minerals that I have just sitting around, but they're one of those things that I don't 100% know what they're used for, so I kind of err to the side of I might need them. Alright, we have received our steel watering can, which is actually great. There we go. Sort that stuff out. Alright. Let's process some geodes. What's this Omni Geode got for us? That's probably going to go to Gunther. Yep. We have plenty of room for all this stuff. I mean, stone is fine. We're getting a lot of stuff to donate as well, which is incredible. All right, that can just get sold back to Clint. Copper ore is always good. I'm never disappointed to see copper ore. I mean, some people might be. Not me. Especially, like, if we want to start building kegs or tappers en masse, we're gonna need just a ton of copper. All right, so let's head over to Gunther's now. Yeah, we just got a ton of stuff to donate. That was actually very lucrative. All right, donate to the museum. You can have this. You can also have this. We got a new reward, which is exciting. Another new reward. And I guess this drum can go over here? That is, what, like three rewards right there? Oh, right, all this stuff, okay. I don't know why I was so surprised. I remember that now, that those three tend to, you know, come in a pair like that. I'm gonna stop by the beach real quick. Why is this all the way over here? We got like pushed out of the way with geodes. All right, there's a lost book, which is fine. We'll eventually get through all of those. Got these new shoes yesterday because my old pair had a brown smudge. I just threw them into the garbage. I would have donated them, but I don't like the idea of some weirdo wearing my shoes, you know? What? Oh man, that is the most American thing I have ever heard. Just like, hey, toss it out. Who needs it? Ooh, this is like honestly what I was hoping for. I didn't want to say it and like jinx myself. That is actually going to get sold, I think. Let's go see how much Willie will give us for the Silver Star Rainbow Shell. 375, that's not bad. Yeah, let's just get rid of it. I mean, as far as I know, we've done the only task that actually requires us to have a rainbow shell. So I don't feel bad about getting rid of that. No, I should head back and sell that. Whatever. We need to go water our crops is what we need to do. Emily usually cooks dinner, but she makes weird stuff like quinoa? Is that how that's pronounced? Quinoa, right? I've never had quinoa, but like I've had vegan food and vegetarian food. Like, man, it's not bad. I think there's just like a stigma around vegan and vegetarian food because like, sure, I guess some of them can be like a little in your face about their diets, but like that doesn't mean the food is bad. This stuff is just gonna go in here for now. I should make another chest. Now, moral of the story is eat what you want to eat and like let other people eat what they want to eat. Unless you're literally a nutritionist and somebody is coming to you for your professional services, in which case like probably do your job and tell people what they should eat. But that's just a you know, my two cents. So our watering is actually going to go quite a bit quicker now that we have this fancy new watering can. No. Just aim the correct direction, please. With the copper one, I could do three in a row without having to, like, step further. This one's just like, no, we can't do that anymore. It's actually rather annoying. Alright, how far? Now I have to, like, replan my, watering pattern here. Got me all thrown off. Oop. We are just barely out of water as well. Which, to be fair, if I just stop turning the wrong direction, probably sort that out. Okay. Crops are watered. We don't have any chickens to worry about just yet. We could rectify that situation today if we were so inclined. I guess we can go talk to Marnie real quick. Wizard Tower, I think he's only awake or whatever, receiving guests, so to speak, until like 8-ish. Marnie's only open to like 4, though. Alright, purchase animals. 800 for a chicken. Yeah, let's do it. Let's get actually a couple of chickens. Chicard, sure. The random names can be pretty pretty good in this game. All right, we'll do 2 chickens for now. And Zeb, beautiful. Okay. We should talk to Marnie as well because I do want to get in there to get the mayor's shorts back. All right. How are we doing friendship wise? Marnie, one heart. I'll make you like me. Just you wait. Oh, we can also go see the traveling merchant today. All in all, a full day. Like, a lot of running around. A lot of busy work. Which isn't a bad thing. Alright. Cockle, a bunch of cave carrots, a lobster, wheat seeds, wood floor. Honestly, nothing I'm interested in here. Like, we're gonna get yams in the fall anyway. Yeah, just, last time, like, Friday, I guess, you were really on the ball. You had a bunch of stuff that I was interested in. Less so today. Hang on, didn't we get... Oh, we did get the, lightning rod recipe at the very end of last episode. I kind of skimmed over that. Alright, here. You can have that. Ah, this is imbued with potent arcane energies. It's very useful for my studies. Thank you. You are very welcome. Dude, you've told me about how you spy on people in the village, and, like, it makes me uncomfortable, and it makes them uncomfortable. I wish you wouldn't do this thing. Like, you should probably respect people's privacy. Okay. And actually, looking at that, friendship screen reminded me that we need to go deliver that jade for Sebastian, who could be, like, anywhere. Let's check how much hay we have as well. Okay, we are full on hay, which is fantastic. And our grass is, like, grown almost back up to the coop. Jade, right. I mean, it is our only one. But he's gonna give us like 600 gold for it. So I feel like that's totally worth it. Alright, it's like 4:30 on a Sunday. If I were Sebastian, where would I be? Maybe hanging out with Sam? We can go check. Alternatively, he could be staring mournfully into the sea. That's a thing he likes to do. What else does he do? Smokes by the lake at night. Alright, so... he's not in here with Sam. Or at least, you know, they're not at Sam's place. Maybe he's down this direction? Oh, there's Elliot. I haven't seen him in a while. He came all the way here just to talk to me. How kind. You know, I think you're good people, Elliot, so I will make an extra effort to come see you. Okay. He's also not down there. Before we do anything... I'm busy, can't you tell? I mean, I guess. Here. Melissa. Oh, because you're in here every day, man. Alright, they're not over here playing pool. There's Marnie. I think, like, Abigail and Sebastian and Sam only come... and hang out at the saloon on, like, Fridays? Or Saturdays, maybe? It's up to Demetrius. It's good to take a break from work every now and then. I guess it's kind of difficult when you live on a farm, though. Hey, at least you have the win- at least in the winter, you don't have to worry about crops. This is technically true. Well, that also means money's a lot tighter. Yeah, I think it's only Friday that they hang out at the saloon. Oh. Robin's up here alone. There he is. I hope Demetrius doesn't blow the house up with those science experiments of his. I'm not even sure what he's working on. I think it has something to do with plants. I mean, probably you're not going to get an explosion with plants, but you also never know. All right, here you go. Hey, thanks for the help. This is just what I wanted. I usually only go outside after dark. Does that sound weird to you? I mean, not really. I am not much for the sun myself, especially not in the summertime, which I have spoken of ad nauseum. Like, it's like, I don't know, 8:45 or 9 o'clock this morning, and my roommate was leaving for work, and she's like, oh, hey, it's like 80 degrees outside already. I'm like, why do you want to hurt me? Like, why do you bring this suffering to me? This isn't information I needed. I hadn't planned to leave the apartment today. Like, I got stuff to do, man. But now I have that knowledge that just outside my door is the surface of the sun. It was like that yesterday, too. All right, what else do we have to do today? I guess we can come check on our chicks, right? They are sleeping. Zeb is trying to sleep, and Chicard is trying to sleep. All right, well, good night, chicken friends. And now I have to remember to go down there and let them out every morning. You know what I'm going to do? Well, I'm thinking about it. Take a couple of those, take one of these. Let's make a lightning rod or two. 5 bat wings, huh? Well, we have plenty of those. Just since it's supposed to storm tomorrow, I would like to get one down this evening. We could put it like right over here, I guess. Sort of away from the crops. You know, like not crop adjacent, but not so far away that it's rendered useless. I actually have no idea how the lightning rods and lightning strikes, like, work, I guess. Like, is it randomly decided if it'll strike anywhere, or, like, if lightning were going to strike all the way over here, and I have a lightning rod over by the house, would that lightning rod still take priority as the target? I don't know. I'm gonna smelt up the stuff for another one, though, before we head to bed here. Just that way, because I know for a fact, if a lightning rod has been struck and is processing the lightning, it will not get struck again. So I want a couple of lightning rods on the farm. One is not enough. Okay. Let's craft this bad boy. Then we can, drop it like right here, I guess. And we'll have the equipment for another one first thing in the morning. So let's just go ahead and head to bed. Yeah, go to sleep for the night. All right, made like almost 500 gold overnight just from forage and minerals and so forth. All right, so it is storming today. Say hi to the Doug. Weather report. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Spirits are very happy today. What's living off the land have to say? Yep, seasonal calendar. I am aware we can also eventually acquire a calendar of our own. Oh, we have blueberries today. Okay, so our lightning rod has been struck already. Well, no, do not eat the blueberry. Just harvest them. Our melons are starting to come in as well. It's nice not having to water today. Well, we also can't let our chicks out since it's raining. So we'll have to come in here. There you go. All right, they both look fine, which is fantastic. Might as well chop this stuff down. Okay, there we go. Alright, let's, clicked shift on accident instead of clicking, control. Alright, let's go ahead and set that there as well. We're gonna have a ton of battery packs now. I might just do, like, a line of them there along the house. Yeah. What else are we... Actually, I think this might be the last one that I do. I don't want to use too much of our iron, although we do already have 3 iron tools. Okay, so what do we do with the rest of today? We could head down to the mine if we wanted to. We definitely want to sell these blueberries off. We don't need them for anything. We're getting close to the end of the season, so I do want to start saving some money. Although I am tempted to smelt up some copper bars and upgrade our hoe at least once, because it will make tilling the land for our crops come fall a lot easier. I initially overlooked the hoe as sort of, you know, an unnecessary upgrade my first playthrough, and I came to regret that. So I might want to work on that here starting today. Oh, store is open now. How's it going, Pierre? You don't need to, like, do your sales pitch every time I come in here. 110 for a single blueberry. And then almost 9,600 gold for the rest of them. This is beautiful. Ooh, I actually kind of like that flooring. I don't want to upgrade any of my, or alter, I guess, any of my flooring or wallpaper until the house is fully upgraded. Because when you upgrade the house, everything gets all rearranged. Yeah, we don't have any gold bars, unfortunately. And we're not quite to floor 65 in the mines yet, so... It's gonna be a minute before we get sprinklers going, really. Alright, well, let's do this. Crafting menu. There we go. I mean, we've survived storms in the past without lightning rods, but I would much, much rather not lose any crops. So, we just let those 3 sit there. Yeah, just take all that. We don't technically need all of it, but... I probably shouldn't chop down all of these saplings, but is what it is. Snag some hardwood here. Maybe once we submit our hoe for upgrading, we'll actually head down to the magical forest and start collecting some more hardwood. And maybe that's what we'll do, depending on... I'm not going to do it before fall. But depending on how things look financially after we've bought our first round of seeds, I may choose to upgrade the house the first time. I'm probably going to want a second scarecrow, because I think like most of this area is going to be crops come fall. I'm trying to remember what we can use battery packs for. We can use them for, like, some lamps or something, stuff that we don't have yet. Take a drink of water there real quick. Wait for this copper bar to finish smelting. You know what? If we have time, I'm going to go visit the wizard as well. Because I feel like he has something to do with these statues. I've still managed to avoid spoiling myself on what those, statues do, if they do anything at all. And I would like to keep it that way. I'd like to discover that for myself. That's part of the magic of this game. Much like, the, you know, the magic of Dark Souls, discovering a lot of things for yourself. I'm hoping we'll have one more blueberry harvest before the end of the season. I'm not 100% sure if we will, but I think so. It'll be like one of the last couple of days. Alright, let's upgrade our tools. Copper hoe. Alright, so we got about 2 days before we need that, so that'll be the 24th. Then if we submit it again on the 24th, it'll be the 26th. So we could go, if we had the money for it and we wanted to, all the way to a steel pickaxe or steel hoe this season. I might want to do that because we are going to want a ton of crops come fall. All right, let's go talk to our wizard friend. We'll grab this sweet pea on the way. Oh, I picked the worst direction to come from. Yeah, okay, maybe this isn't so bad. I guess I've cleared a path out in the past already. I have returned with yet another gift. Yep, I'm aware. Stormy days are the only time I can commune with certain elementals. I don't expect you to understand. Well, I mean, that's a little condescending. Like, hey, I have very, very specific knowledge of this topic. I don't expect you to understand it. Like, no shit. Alright, we are going in here without a weapon, so hopefully our any slimes can just... Oh, jeez. Oh, that's doing one whole damage. That's fantastic. I knew that's exactly what was going to happen. Get off of me, dog. I'm not super worried about our HP, but there are way more slimes here than I expected there to be. Maybe something to do with the fact that it's raining? I don't know if more slimes actually come out while it's raining, but, you know. It is what it is. Pick up that real quick. Hey, you can just, like... Get out of here, man. Okay. Alright, if you can just, like, jump over here. Alright, he had already jumped. I would like to contest that. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, I mean, our HP is not bad. The tracking on that shot was some, like, it was outrageous. Dude was, like, laser-focused. All right, well, that's another 12 hardwood, anyway. I think we have all the stumps on the farm taken care of. Oh, Marnie's not going to be there. We could go talk to her at the bar, though. Oh, no, I'm... Well, stumps maybe. The logs, obviously not. Let's go talk to Marnie. at the bar, presumably. Oh, the annoying thing is this corn is still going to be in the way. I should have thought about that. I might be willing to sacrifice those two pieces of corn, though, to have a path directly down to our chicken coop. I might decide that that's worth it. Alright, let's come in here. Bunch of people. Let's just talk to everybody. Alright, well, Harvey's a little less awkward now when he talks to us anyway. Not really, but I appreciate the concern. I do note, however, that Marnie is not here. Oh, these two are here on Monday. Sure. I wish I could catch a frog and give it to Sebastian. Shane's warming up to us, it seems. Yeah, he's up at 2 hearts now. How is Emily up at 3 already? I didn't think we talked to her that much. Haley's a picky eater. It's so hard to cook for her. It's interesting hearing both sides of the food argument. All right, I suspect that Marnie just isn't coming to the bar tonight. So, yes, we do. Okay. I just got the thought in my head. I'm like, we haven't been to the community center in 20 whole minutes. Let's go check that out. And I actually do have something that we need to drop off. All right, bulletin board, chef's bundle. Oh, we've already done it. Right. I'm an idiot. I looked at the top part, but I didn't bother to look at the bottom part. Okay, well. Serves me right for being smug. What else was I gonna do? Oh, I was gonna mine out... I guess not mine, but chop down some of those logs and get some hardwood. I mean, I might as well, right? Just a few more days for our melons to be done. Alright. Oh, there's another stump over here. This whole, like, half of the farm that we never go on to. Just because it's, like... actually super overgrown. Yeah, the best part is I could clear out all these rocks and stuff, and more are just gonna show up come fall. So unless you really commit to clearing the farm, you're kind of fighting a losing battle. I'm not really going to commit to it, because I actually don't mind having all this stuff here. Because I don't really need this area yet. I just specifically want the hardwood. Because, like, we have, what, like 50 or so in the chest already? I think we need 100 for our first house upgrade. And it is, like, 1040. So I'm gonna, I guess, just chop this last stump down. There's a ton of them over here. All right, this is actually gonna be the last stump I chop down, because this will give us an even 50. Wait, what? Those are only 2? All right, I'm gonna get exactly 50 hardwood, and then I'm gonna go to bed. And it's gonna be an episode. Okay, go. put this stuff in its appropriate place. But like a ton of stone. I guess that boulder gives you like way more stone than I expected it to. Alright, that can go in there. Ton of common mushrooms. We might as well collect those. That and that can go in there. It is going to start getting late here soon, but I'm not overly concerned about it. All right, that and that. Yeah, we have 109 hardwood now. All right, all that stuff can go in there. All right, that's going to do it for this episode. If you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time.